Hello and welcome. My name's George, and my channel's normally all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today, we're doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be upgrading the internal storage of my M4 Mac Mini. When I first bought my Mac Mini a few months ago, I went with the base model as far as storage goes. So I got the Mac Mini with 256 gigabytes of SSD storage. And I knew that this wasn't going to be enough for me, but I also knew that you can actually upgrade the internal storage of the M4 Mac Mini on your own. Now, this is something that Apple hasn't wanted you to do for many years, but some great folks online have figured out how to do it specifically with the M4 chip. At the time of this recording, you can't do it with the M4 Pro, which is one of the reasons why I opted for just the base M4 model. So let's dive in and I'll show you exactly how I did this. So I purchased the internal storage from expandmacmini.com, and they have a 2 terabyte chip for the Mac Mini M4. And you can see it looks like they're working on one for the Mac Mini M4 Pro. But at this time in July of 2025, that's not out yet. And you can see the current price is $320 compared to the Apple price of an extra $800 to upgrade to the 2 terabyte SSD. So you're saving quite a bit of money doing this upgrade yourself. Now, included in the kit, you also get a screwdriver with multiple bits, all the bits that you need. This is my old hard drive in there. And also these little plastic and metal pry things that you need to pry open the Mac Mini case. So all the tools you need to do the upgrade are included in the kit. Now there's 2 sets of instructions that I use to do this. The first is the guide on their website. And this guide is actually just for the restore. So you actually need a second Mac to restore all the operating system onto your Mac Mini. So as you can see here, you need a Mac of 2015 or newer. I used a MacBook Pro from 2019, which was an Intel chip, and everything worked just fine. And on that second computer, the host computer, you need to download the Apple Configurator app from the App Store. And you also need to download the firmware file, which is right here. The other set of instructions that I followed were from the iFixit website that you can see here. And I just kind of scrolled as I went to follow that and made sure that I carefully followed these steps. So now let's go ahead and actually open up our Mac Mini and do this upgrade. Okay, so let's start by unboxing the hard drive kit. And you can see the hard drive there. And those are the pry tools that we're going to use to open up the case. And we have our screwdriver, which includes 3 different bits. So I'm starting by turning over the Mac Mini upside down. Now there's 4 little clips that you have to detach in order to open up the bottom of the Mac Mini. So I first used the metal one to pry it open a little bit, and then tried to jimmy in the plastic pick afterwards. And I actually did scratch the bottom a little bit with the metal pick, so you want to be careful with that. So eventually I did get the plastic pick in there. And then it's just a matter of kind of sliding back and forth to try and pry those little clips open. And they're in all four corners. And they're a little tricky. What I ended up doing was kind of twisting the pick, and that kind of popped them open. This is probably the hardest part of the whole process, actually. Just not wanting to break anything right off the bat. So here you can see they're starting to come loose. I'm just kind of twisting the plastic pick a little bit to get those to pop open. Now everything's starting to come free. I'm just going to pop open the back plate and turn it over. Now you want to be careful because there is the power button still attached. You'll see the little cable there. Now in the iFixit instructions, they tell you to unhook and remove the cable. You don't actually need to do this to get through the whole process. So I chose just to leave it attached. It seemed pretty fragile, so I thought it was easier just to leave it there and work around it. Now, the next step is to remove the 8 screws. There's 3 each in the top 2 corners and 1 each in the bottom 2 corners. And you just want to be real careful that you don't strip the screws. And also, you want to make sure that you keep the screws organized. So I usually place them in the table, kind of in the area that they came from, and in the same order. And you kind of have to move that plate out of the way to get the 3rd screw right beside the power button. Now, the next step is to remove the next plate, and you kind of want to pull it towards you a little bit before lifting upwards. And again, there's another cable attached to this one, so you want to be careful, once again, not to just pull it up quickly. So you can just kind of lay that beside the Mac Mini, like you can see I'm doing. And now the next step is to remove the fan. And the 2 top screws are actually a different size than the 2 bottom screws. So you'll have to change the bit. Now, with all of those 4 screws off, we can take off the fan. And once again, there's a cable attached to the fan. So we need to be careful with that again. Now, once again, the iFixit instructions tell you to remove the cable for the fan, but you don't actually need to do this. So once again, I just left it hooked up and just moved it out of the way. And now the next step is to remove the screw for the SSD hard drive. And again, you'll have to change the bit on the screwdriver for this. This screw is probably the tightest of all of them. Now, to remove the hard drive, it needs to be backed out a little bit. And I ended up using the screwdriver, and there's kind of 2 little pins on each side of the SSD drive, and I just kind of stuck the end there and kind of just wiggled and backed it out a little bit. And then from there, I was able to just use my hands and remove the SSD hard drive. So now we're on to installing our new SSD hard drive. And you want to start it at a little bit of an angle and push it in and just make sure it's nice and fully seated there. And then you can go ahead and replace the screw. And again, just make sure everything's fully seated. And now it's time to put everything back in the reverse order. So starting with the fan, we'll get that back into position and screw down the four screws that go with it. And then we'll go ahead and replace the inner plate. And again, there's 8 screws for that. And lastly, we'll just press the case back all together, and those just snap in to those clips, and you'll feel them kind of snap once they're seated. And in order to restore the Mac Mini, we need to hook it up to another Mac. So I have it hooked up to my 2019 MacBook Pro here. So you just need a USB-C cable or Thunderbolt cable going from one computer to the next. Then I'm hooking up my monitor to the Mac Mini. And lastly, you have to hold down the power button for 10 seconds without the power cable hooked up. And then while you continue to hold the power button, you're going to put in the power cable, and then you should see it blinking orange there, and then you know we're in recovery mode and we can start to transfer over all the system files again from my laptop over to the Mac Mini. So you're going to need to download the Apple Configurator app from the App Store. And then the other thing you're going to need to download is the firmware file, which is linked on the instruction page here. Okay, now we can see that Apple Configurator is in the DFU mode. So now we just need to restore the firmware for the Mac Mini here. So we need to grab the IPSW file that we previously downloaded. So I'll go find that, and I'll simply just drag the file on here, and then we're going to go ahead and click restore, and now we just wait patiently. Okay, looks like we're getting close here. I'm just going to hook up my keyboard and mouse to my Mac Mini. Just a quick disclaimer that I had to film my monitor using a camera rather than a screen share like I normally do, because the screen sharing software obviously isn't installed yet while I'm restoring my Mac Mini. Okay, and let's go ahead and click next. And looks like we're all good. We're just gonna do our basic setup here. Select your country. Before I took my Mac Mini apart, I of course backed up my system. I just used Time Machine for this, as I've only been using the Mac for about a month or so, so I don't have a ton of things loaded on, so I felt pretty confident with the Time Machine backup. Or you could use something like Carbon Copy Cloner, which will create an exact clone of your hard drive. So I'm going to go ahead and plug my hard drive in and get it to restore from the Time Machine backup. So I'll go continue and continue again. Not now. I'm going to continue without Wi-Fi for now. And here's my Time Machine backup. Go ahead and select that, go continue. And here we can see my Mac Mini select that, continue. Now you can select what you want to transfer. I'm going to go ahead and transfer everything. So I'll go continue. And now we just wait for the migration process to complete. Okay, so everything's been now restored on my Mac Mini. And let's just go ahead and confirm that the storage and everything is working properly. So I'm going to go to my system settings and then storage. And now we can see 196 of 2 terabytes used. So I have 1.8 terabytes of space remaining, which is awesome. So now I've got space to go ahead and load the things that I previously couldn't, such as all of the Logic Pro software instruments and some third-party software instruments as well. So I'm really happy to see that this all worked out the way I had hoped. So if you're someone who's a little handy and doesn't mind opening up your Mac Mini, then this is definitely a cheaper alternative to go to rather than getting the upgrade directly from Apple when you first order your Mac Mini. I will admit it is a little nerve-wracking opening up your fresh Mac Mini and hoping that everything goes as it should. But if you take your time and you're careful, it really wasn't that difficult. Probably took me about half an hour to do the actual install of the hard drive while following all the instructions online nice and carefully. And then restoring all the software and everything, that's kind of what took the longest. So as I said, if you feel comfortable doing this, then definitely something you want to look into if you have just the base storage in your M4 Mac Mini. If you have any questions about anything related to the process of upgrading your internal storage for your M4 Mac Mini, make sure to leave those in the comments below. And I'll be happy to answer them. And before I let you go, if you're like me and you use your Mac Mini for music production and use Logic Pro, then make sure to download my free Logic Pro Ultimate Starter Pack. This includes my Logic Pro Session Templates, my Logic Pro Hotkey Cheat Sheet, my Audio Recording Guide, my Mixing Guide, and my Gear Guide. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.